Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and the dear guests. Welcome to the meeting number 410. Do you want to see a sharp change in your personality, your communication skills, public speaking skills, and confidence levels? Then, my dear friends, you must look for Toastmasters Club. The Toastmasters Club has already served and is serving a large number of people to achieve their personal goals. People join Toastmasters for a numerous reasons, some for improving their personality, some for exceeding their networks, and some for discovering their own potential. Now, I would like to share you all the mission of our club. We provide a supportive and positive learning experience in which members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, which results in greater self-confidence and personal growth. When you least expect it, something great will come along. Something better than you ever expected. Just be patient, stay calm, stay focused, and stay positive. Now, I would like to introduce you all to the president of Central Delhi Toastmasters Club. He's a passionate Toastmaster and a passionate problem solver. He's always ready to help the club members and leads the club through his own example. Currently, he is working as the consultant to Government of India in NITI Aayog. He's a man of words and is always praised for the vocab he uses. Now, please back me welcome to invite the president of Central Delhi Toastmasters Club, Toastmaster Karthik Bhatia.
Thank you, Kashish, for that great introduction. Before we move ahead, I would request everyone to please close your eyes for 30 seconds, pray for world peace, and let's pray that this pandemic gets over very quickly. Thank you, everyone. Well, today, let's talk about a man who gave us the luxury of having great and affordable burgers, Mr. Ray Kroc of McDonald's. Mr. Ray Kroc joined the army at the age of 15 by lying about his age. After serving in the army, he returned to Chicago and did various jobs for almost 20 years, from being a jazz pianist, a real estate salesman, and selling paper cups, often doing all of these jobs, multiple jobs at the same time. He then went into the business of selling milkshakers to restaurants. 10 years into the business, in 1954, he visited a restaurant that had 8 of his milkshakers. This restaurant was owned by two brothers named Maurice and Richard McDonald. He was awestruck by the efficient assembly line style of making burgers and fries and serving them to the customers in very quick speed. He then made a deal with the brothers to open these outlets, which will have the same model of working style and marketing around whole of USA. This is also when the concept of franchisee business was born into the world. Now, what made McDonald's was so big was Mr. Kroc's insistence on training programs and standardization of McDonald's operation. You may actually be surprised to know that there's actually a university set up by McDonald's to teach how people can prepare and serve burgers. Now, McDonald's was making money out of real estate as well, not just the burger business. With its franchise seeing a meteoric rise, Mr. Kroc got the two brothers who owned the original restaurant be bought out. The two brothers that had actually started the chain had to be bought out, and then McDonald's was owned as a subsidiary of which Mr. Kroc was part of. But none of this stopped Mr. Kroc. And McDonald's is today the largest food chain in the world and still profitable to this day after so many years. Now, why is the story of someone like Ray Kroc important to us? Now, often in your life, mostly in your work life, you'll see a lot of people where they'll tell you that they are way past their prime and whatever they had to achieve has already been achieved. And now it's time for them to just walk on their laid down path of their career. And they'll also tell you that if you make a specific choice in your career, your life is locked. And that is how far you will ever go. Now, the idea is to tell you that you have never hit your peak until you are convinced you have. Age or qualification are no bar to achieving what you want in life. Whatever you do, wherever you are capable enough of making your dreams a reality. Thank you. That was my bit on the inspiring story, at least very inspiring for me, of Mr. Ray Kroc. At this point, I would like to acknowledge the presence of the immediate past international president of Toastmasters International, DTM Deepak Menon is with us. He's also a proud member of our club and very regularly, he attends every single meeting and helps the club in various activities. Thank you,
sir. Mr. President, may I have a word?
Yes, please.
I have told you this plenty times and I'd like to repeat this. You need to stop introducing me like this. I'm just like any other member of the club. So please don't put me on the spot every time.
It's our honor and privilege and we won't let you go easily, sir.
Thank you.
Let's talk to the guests who have joined us today. I see guest Shekhar. Guest Shekhar, can you please turn on your video, unmute your mic, introduce yourself. Guest Shekhar.
Hello. Hello, my name is Shekhar Sakya. I'm a software engineer based in Gurugram. I'm from Assam and this is my second session as a guest. Thank you.
Glad to have you back, Shekhar. Thank you. Next up, I see guest Mehak. Guest Mehak, please turn on your video, unmute your mic, introduce yourself, and let us know how did you get to know about our club.
Hello, am I audible?
Yes, you are.
Hi, everyone. I got to know about Toastmasters from a friend of mine in college. At present, I'm in third year of my graduation, pursuing DMS from Shaheed Rajguru College, Delhi University.
Thank you. Thank you, Mehak, for introducing yourself. And I'm sure you'll have a great time in the meeting. Do we have any other guests joining in today? I don't see much. If I'm missing anyone can help me out. All right. Okay, so to both the guests that have joined, we'll have a table topic session where you guys can also participate. So please stick around for the full 2 hours and do participate in that table topic session. All right. At this point, let's welcome the host of the meeting to take the proceedings forward. Let's welcome Toastmaster Ankit Sinha with his theme, Which is Your Favorite Color? Which is your favorite color by Toastmaster Ankit Sinha.
Yellow, blue, white, gray, indigo, and many more. Colors are everywhere. We attach to them in all aspects of our life. But do you know that color tells a lot about person's personality? And we can know that which type of person is this, at least broadly. So today I'm going to share a bit about the personalities as per the choice of persons. And with this, I welcome you all in meeting number 410 of the Central Day Toastmasters Club. So friends, do you know that people who like red color have which kind of nature? Any idea? Anyone? Can you guess this?
Calm.
Okay, calm. Anyone else?
They are full of rage.
Full of anger. Rage.
Anger.
Mm. Anger. What's your word? So I believe Kartik, Toastmaster Kartik and Gurusipad are quite right. People who like red color are extrovert, optimistic, courageous and confident. They always want to remain center of attraction and they are achievement oriented. Second place is not good enough. Which for them, it's all or nothing. So any idea for color orange? Any idea for color orange? Anyway, let me share with you that people who like orange color are not aggressive like red color person, but they are very assertive. They enjoy partying and socializing. Rather, you can say they are social animals and they get deep satisfaction in helping others. So friends, I will share you more about these different colors and I will tell you that which role player likes which color. So before moving further, let me share with you the structure of the meeting. We have three segments. First is prepared speeches. We have three speakers. They are going to present their speeches that they are preparing for the last 4-5 days. And today they are going to give a final touch. And the evaluator will tell them whether they have become successful or not. So that means these speakers will present their speech on certain objectives. Evaluators will evaluate and evaluators will give its report in the segment number 3. You must be thinking I skipped segment number 2. Segment number 2 is for everyone. Segment number 2 for members, for guests, anyone can participate. And only the table topic master knows that what is going to happen. Here you cannot prepare like the first segment. You will be called if you are courageous enough and like red color, then you will be called on the stage, will be given topic and 1 to 2 minutes you will speak. More will be elaborated by a table topic master. Guests must be thinking that there is a different segments and why this for everything is master denoted. Obviously, since we are Toastmasters, so we are putting master in everything. So nothing to think about much. In the third segment, everything will be evaluated. Friends, what is the beauty of Toastmaster is that no one is beyond evaluation, except general evaluator. Except general evaluator, everything, say it's role players, it's speakers, it's evaluator, everything is evaluated. We have today general evaluator Toastmaster Shivali. So friends, let's begin with segment number 1. But before beginning segment number 1, I would like to share some more role players. These role players are extremely important. Just imagine you have been given a task to give a speech. Allotted time is 10 minutes, but you spoke just 7 minutes. Rather, you exceeded the time limit, 12 minutes. Friends, you cannot be termed as a good speaker, rather efficient speaker. So in order to check this thing, we have timer. Our first auxiliary role player is timer, and this role is being played by Toastmaster Meher. So please welcome our timer for the day, Toastmaster Meher. Meher, screen is all yours. You can unmute and start.
Good evening, Toastmasters and dear guests. I think our today's theme, colors, is so interesting, as colors make our world so beautiful. Besides, they also influence our mood. I'll give you an example. We love spending more and more time in gardens and greenery. This is because the vibrant colors of flowers and different shades of green inculcates liveliness in us. On the contrary, we tend to spend less time in a place which has a bit dull colors. Similarly, in public speaking, people engage more with the speeches and table topics if they are short, crisp, and energetic, just like the bright colors. So today, to prevent the overlonging of our answers, I'll play the role of timer and will remind each speaker of time they have left using green, yellow, and red cards. And I'll present my report in the evaluation segment. Back to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, timer of the day. So friends, do you know that which is Toastmaster Meher's favorite color? Toastmaster Meher's favorite color is the color white. People who like white color have high standards for their life. They are very, very positive. They are practical, down to earth, but they are quite cautious in terms of money. They think carefully before taking any kind of decision. So with this, it's time to welcome our next role player, because our language evaluator is all ready, all set. It's very, very clear from his face that he's ready. So I will not waste further time. Let's invite our language evaluator, Toastmaster Vineet Nayak. Vineet, stage is all yours.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ankit. The logic of color is a matter of science, but the magic of color is rooted in the emotions, and it is the quality which makes it the primary ingredient to have a vision in life. Good evening to all fellow Toastmasters and esteemed guests. I'll be playing the role of language evaluator today. I'll be noting down the good usages and not so good usages of English language throughout the meeting. The word of the day is adulation, which means excessive or slavish admiration or flattery. Kindly encourage the speaker who uses the word of the day by showing a thumbs up. Mode of communication is English, so kindly translate into English if you use any other language. I will make my observations and submit my report during the evaluation segment. Over to you, Toastmaster Ankit.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster. So friends, do you know that which is our language evaluator's favorite color? Any idea?
Red.
Red, okay. Our language evaluator's favorite color is color blue. That means a color which is preferred by around 70% of the males. So friends, people who like blue color are conservative, but reliable and trustworthy. They take their own time in selecting persons as a friend. They always think before speak, and they have their own pace. They take their own time for completing anything. For them, peace and harmony is the most important thing. They don't want sudden disturbance in their lives. So with this, let's welcome our next role player. Our next role player is Toastmaster Faiz. And Toastmaster Faiz is playing a counter for them. Let's move. Faiz, stage is all yours.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ankit. Am I audible?
Yes, you are 100% audible.
Thank you so much. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. My name is Faiz Kamil. As Toastmaster of the day, Ankit has already introduced the topic of the day, which is color psychology, which argues that a person's favorite color defines or says a lot about his personality traits. Similarly, excessive usage of fillers in your speeches tells how underconfident a speaker is. Today, I am playing a role of AH counter. I will be counting the filler words used by each of these speakers today. Filler words like oh, and repetitive phrases like, you know what I mean, etc. And short and long pauses. The purpose of this zoom is to make you conscious about the filler words which we use unconsciously, so that you improve in your next speeches and you don't and ultimately you give a better speech and don't lose your audience attention. At the end of the meeting, I will be showing you the stats for the same. Thank you so much. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Faiz. And friends, do you know that black is Toastmaster Faiz's favorite color? And people who like black, for them, prestige and power is the most important thing. They want to remain in control of themselves and also of the situation. They are so disciplined that they remain authoritarian, dictatorial, even to their friends or colleagues. I may be wrong, so disclaimer is there, though it's not scrolling there, but disclaimer is there that these things may relate to you or may not relate to you. So friends, with this, let's move on to our next role player, that is parliamentarian, and Toastmaster Tarun Nanda is all set to share more about his role. Screen is all yours, Toastmaster Tarun.
Yeah. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ankit. A very good evening to fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. As the theme of the day is about your favorite color. So it can be of quite important as it tell you about yourself. So as we can see that color are a part of our lives and experiences. So it affects our emotions, and also it impacts on our subconscious. So today I'm playing and acting as a role of parliamentarian. I welcome you all and let you all aware with the rules of the meeting and also discipline to be maintained during the meeting. So first, everyone should keep their audio muted at all times unless there is a need to speak. And video should be kept on at all the times during the meeting. And third, no one should indulge in any form of eating during the meeting. And fourthly, all the speakers should be take care that no references should be given to no negative references should be given to the caste, gender, religion, or politics. So I request you all that let us encourage each other that rules strictly being followed during the meeting. And because more we are disciplined, more we are going to learn from these Toastmasters. So thank you so much for the day. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Tarun. Thank you for elaborating about your role. And friends, do you know that which is Tarun's favorite color? Tarun's favorite color is blue. Blue, I have already explained it. So let's move on to our next role player. That is a listener for the day. And this role is being played by Toastmaster Kashish Jain. So please welcome Toastmaster Kashish.
Be unique, you. Stand out, shine, be colorful. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. I, Kashish Jain, will be playing the role of listener in today's meeting. Listening is not just a skill. It is an ability to communicate well, speak well, know other person's perception, and become a prominent personality. Remember one thing. When you speak, you tell the thing that you know. But when you listen, you will definitely learn something new. So make sure the more you listen carefully, the better you will speak. So I, Kashish Jain, will be playing the role of listener, and as my role, I will be preparing the questions from the entire meeting. And at the evaluation session, I will be asking those questions which I expect that you will answer me correctly. So be attentive, listener. Learn something new from the entire meeting, because these meetings are very crucial and which that will surely help you to learn something new. So be attentive, answer my questions, and I will be back with my questions from the evaluation session. So over to you, the Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Kashish. And friends, as requested by our president, we have 25 persons present here. Video is on only 12%. So friends, if you can switch on, I understand that since you are sitting at your home, it's not convenient all the time to switch on. You can have a blur background, or at least you can switch on when the situation is comfortable. So it's this thing gives confidence to all the role players. At least someone is listening, and they, because they are making sense, they have put lots of effort in preparing for their roles. And just, we are going to have a speech segment soon, because, and they have devoted so much time in preparing their content. So friends, do pay some time. In case of physical meeting, we have to be there, but I suggest you just consider it as a physical meeting, not 2 hours, at least 1.5 hours. Be here and encourage all of us. Thank you. Thank you so much, because some of the videos have been switched on. And thank you so much for heeding my request. And friends, do you know that which is Toastmaster Kashish's favorite color? Kashish is an evergreen personality and he likes green. So friends, green means a person who's down to earth, practical. And the person with green color are very compassionate. Obviously, love for nature is there. But the point is that sometimes they don't care of their own needs while helping others. So just a suggestion for them, do take care of your own needs as well. Yes, obviously very, very sensitive person. So friends, it's time to have some laughter. In this tough time where even our president is ill, so I request our joke master to spread some smile to all the faces that we are present here. And so stage is all yours, our joke master, Toastmaster Pooja.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. I am Pooja. So let me first introduce myself. I'm from Kolkata and have moved to Delhi very recently. So I'm an amazing ex-girlfriend, like the one who sends OTP types. I recently downloaded Hinge. Okay, Tinder is too mainstream, right? Like, I'm an artist. So, okay, I love Hinge, okay? And for those of you who don't know what Hinge is, it's a dating app where you can upload like 6 pictures of yours. And you need to select 3 predetermined questions and answer them yourself. So, yes. And I really like spending time on Hinge, you know. I love reading those answers because it tells me how dumb people are. Because you guys have totally nailed the photo game. Like every guy has a perfect photo staring into that black hole with a puppy, with a guitar, with a mic, with a bike. So everything is just on point, right? Okay. But you know what Hinge has? So Hinge has a conversation starter. And you know what Indians are bad at? Starting a conversation. So I was going through this app and found a profile who had answered a simple question. The question was, what are your simple pleasures in life? And he wrote, my simple pleasure in life is watching sea turtle get back into the ocean. Like, so if your simple pleasure is so complicated, dude, I don't want to be in a relationship with you, right? Thank you so much, Toastmasters. Over to the president.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Pooja. And I have handed over back from the president, and ice cream is all mine. So friends, do you know that people who like yellow color? People who like yellow color, anyone who like yellow color? Because the role players, okay, Deepak sir likes yellow color. Anyone else? So friends, do you know that why Deepak sir personality is so distinct? Because he likes yellow color. Yellow color persons are, they always have some idea. You can say they are perfectionist kind of persons, but they like small group. They don't like big gatherings. they keep on analyzing things all the time, and they are quite methodical in their thinking. And I am not surprised that yellow color is liked by our own Deepak sir. So that's why I was thinking that no one has sent me a text that yellow color is my favorite. And today I have got it. Thank you so much, Deepak sir. So friends, with this, let's begin our segment number one, that is prepared speeches. And our speakers are all ready. Friends, do you know that what is common in all the speakers today? Friends, we have three speakers today and all of them like black color. So it's time to welcome our speaker number one, Toastmaster Rohi. Toastmaster Rohi is presenting her project number one, Dynamic Leadership, project number one, that is Icebreaker from Dynamic Leadership Park. And to elaborate more what Toastmaster Rohi is going to achieve, it's time to invite her evaluator, that is Toastmaster Simran Dua. Simran, screen is all yours.
Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. So I would like to say the statement of the speech. So the purpose of this project is for the member to introduce herself to the club and learn the basic structure of a public speech. So I would like to wish all the best to the speaker. Thank you. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Simran. So friends, it's time to welcome Toastmaster Rohi, who is all ready for her, with her speech. So please welcome Toastmaster Rohi, faces of my life, faces of my life. Toastmaster Rohi, Rohi, stage is all yours. Go on.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Toastmaster. You can't connect the dot looking forward. You can connect them only looking backward. This quote of Steve Jobs made me think of my journey of life so far. Today, standing here, I'm going to tell you about four phases of my life which made me who I am today. First phase is innocence phase. Usually, children like going to school where they can meet new friends, make new friends and play. But I hated going to school. I can still remember my mom carrying my shoes, socks, along with me. I used to cry whole way from home to my bus stop. In fact, she had to bribe me to go to school. I was a shy kid, but I liked listening stories. And this eventually created the habit and my hobby of reading novels and storybooks. During my childhood days, I read extensively from fairy tales to adventure novel to mystery novels. As I grew, I focused more on my studies, and in class 11 and 12, I started preparing for IIT. But as the result came, I was devastated because I was not selected. But those 2 years gave me an important life lesson of the balance between work life and professional life. Now my second phase began, which was my independence phase. As a child, I was a pampered kid. I had to do no work. And it was the first time I was going out of my house. So I didn't know how to take care of myself. But the good thing was all other hostel mates were in the same situation. So we all learned together, grew together. And in this process, a strong bond was also created. College life was not just about studies. It was also of discovering myself. I participated in various activities and fairs to know what I like and what I dislike. For example, morning run and going to gym became one of my favorite activity. But since the time does not remain constant, so my carefree day also ended. And so my third phase began, which was my enlightenment phase. In this phase, I moved to Bangalore for my job. Initially, few months were very exciting as I explored Bangalore and also outside of Bangalore with my friends. But after a few months, life became monotonous. So for fun and to meet new people, I joined Toastmaster Club. I was an introvert person during my college days. But in the Toastmaster, I discovered that I am an ambivert person. I like interacting with people of different background, to knowing them, learning from them. While I was in college, I always knew that I wanted to go for higher studies, but I did not knew which path to take. But now, postgraduate program in management became looked like a perfect option to me. So my fourth phase began, and it was a roller coaster ride. From the day one of my MBA, we were told that time was sacrosanct. And I remember that even for the 11 p.m. meeting, even if we were late by 1 second, we were fined heavily. While my bachelor days were carefree days, my MBA life became full of responsibilities. There, I live with people of diverse background of different age group, and this broadened my perspective and made me more open. Confidence comes when you do things by yourself. These few words were said by one of my batchmates to me because I was afraid to do new activities. But it was winning case competition at national level or losing 10 kg weight by myself made me realize that what he said was true. People say that MBA transform you as a person. Earlier, I did not believe it, but now I can see those changes in myself. Even the type of novel which I read has changed from fiction to nonfiction. While the first phase of my life gave me the lesson of work-life balance, the second gave me the lesson of independence, the third of interacting with new people, the fourth phase of my life gave me an important lesson of never to settle. COVID-19 have created a lot of constraints, but before moving on to my next phase, I want to explore myself and to complete the task which I have left in the middle. For this, I have taken various internships to upgrade my skills, as well as started reading extensively again. There is one skill that is effective communication, which I want to master, and I believe that there is no other platform than Toastmaster Club, which can help me in that. So before concluding, I'd like to say that a step towards what you fear is a mile towards mastering it. And I'm happy to take that step today. Thank you.
Friends, how many of you believe that Toastmaster Ruhi puts lots of effort in her speech? So friends, if you believe that, let's unmute yourself and have a big, big round of applause so that she can hear her. So let's unmute and give a big round of applause to her. So she can listen properly. Her effort is being rewarded by that claps. Thank you so much, friends.
Ankit sir, you are on mute.
So friends, it's time to welcome our next speaker. Our next speaker is Toastmaster Shivangi Mittal. Her evaluator is Toastmaster Karanvi, who recently has been applauded by in our group as well, as the message is shared. So friends, she is going to start her journey. Friends, it's really, really difficult. Say it's on a screen or on the stage. To start your journey, you are cautious about each and every line that you say on the stage. So friends, we have second icebreaker today. Before calling her on stage, I would like to call her evaluator, Toastmaster Karanveer, to share the speech objectives that she is going to achieve today. Toastmaster Karanveer.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ankit. A very good evening, fellow Toastmasters and all the guests. Toastmaster Shivangi is going to start her Toastmaster journey today by delivering her level one project one, which is icebreaker speech. The title of the speech is Never Settle. The purpose of the speech is for the member to introduce herself to the club and learn the basic structure of the speech. Timer, please note that the speech timing is from 4 to 6 minutes, and I wish all the very best to the speaker. Thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you,
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Karanveer. So friends, Shivangi is all ready with her speech. She has properly set the camera. So I will not make you wait. And so please welcome Toastmaster Shivangi Mittal, never settle. Toastmaster Shivangi Mittal, Shivangi, stage is all yours.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ankit. I made sure to wear my favorite color today. Okay. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. I'm a first-year student pursuing the BCom Honors program from Devi Sriram College, Delhi University. Now, before I go on, I want you to think about the most misleading advice you've ever gotten. Think about it. Okay, now see if this sounds familiar. Bas 10th kar lo, phir life set hai. Bas 12th kar lo, phir life pakka set hai. Bas college achha mil jaye, phir to party karni hai. Just get through class 10th and then you're set for life. Okay, I can do that. No, get through class 12th and then you're set for life. Right, I can do that. Hold your courses, get a good college first, and then all you have to do is party hard. Okay, done. But wait, not so fast. Coronavirus. It's been one heck of a year with speculations, extending lockdowns, ringing utensils, dalgona coffee, and that's just April 2020. But with all this extra time at hand, I've come up with new ways of learning. A year back, I was struggling to cut down the time I spent on social media, thinking it's unproductive. But to tell you the truth, I still end up scrolling through Instagram for 2 to 3 hours a day. Eventually, I realized I can't seem to cut down on the time. So instead, I tried cutting down on the guilt. That guilt of not doing something productive enough. So I changed the kind of content I consume from following random people's lives to following educational pages. From journalism to communication, from business to marketing, from communication to general awareness. And the current hot topics, startup and investing. To the moon. Now that I think about it, it's not the kind of platform there is to be blamed, but it's the kind of content we choose to consume. It's only until recently that I stopped chasing checkpoints. Back in school, I expected that a good college would serve success on a plate. Or at least spoon feed the recipe for success. No? Well, the hard reality is that the curriculum won't teach you how to get through a job interview or how to build a startup. Even so, the fact that I'm learning from all kinds of sources on the internet, but my textbooks. Now that's something. I'm talking 2 months into the semester and I still haven't touched those books, like they're contagious. But in any case, I think our batch does deserve better. Because technically, our first year in college is over and we still can't go to college. If you ask me, I feel like we're all stuck in a loop, living the same day over and over again. But you know how a Toastmaster can derive a life lesson even from flying words and changing tires. So on the bright side, I think what we're trying to do here is to set smaller goals so the bigger ones don't scare us away. Being one of the youngest Toastmasters here, it's not my place to say, but never settle, if at all you get a chance. In every decision you make, in every path you take, it's a restless rhythm that drives forward. As it happens, things become disappointing when we start romanticizing the idea of success. Bas MBA ho jaye, bas achha package lag jaye, bas Ambani ban jaye. Just get through an MBA, just get a good job. Nothing less than being the next Ambani, huh? I'll tell you what, I'm still in the running. But have you reached the finish line yet? Okay, let's not pull that thread. Guess what I'm rooting for right now? Bas COVID khatam ho jaye. I'm just hoping for the pandemic to end soon. And then, life set. That was all from my side. Thank you for being such patient listeners.
Friends, please unmute yourself and then applaud so that our speaker can listen your applaud. So, dear Toastmasters, what is the difference between CDTM and other clubs? Only in CDTM you have icebreaker of this kind, icebreaker of this level, where even I am putting this statement very seriously. That here you can, I learned so many things from this speech as well as from the last speech. So many things were there. It was very pretty smooth and evaluation will be done by the evaluator, but so many things to learn. Here, it does not matter if it's P1 or P2 or P10. You can learn from any speaker, any role player. So friends, it's time to welcome our next speaker because Toastmaster Akriti has switched on her video and we can see her now. And before calling her on stage, it's time to welcome her evaluator, Toastmaster Digant. Yes, his video is also switched on. So Toastmaster Digant, please share the speech objective, what our VPPR is going to achieve today.
Well, our VPPR is not just handling the social media domain for our club. Now our VPPR is also projecting herself as an enterprising Toastmaster, as she's delivering her first prepared speech. Although icebreaker is just the introduction, but this is the first speech of evaluation and feedback, marking as the starting of her first prepared speech. So the purpose of this project is for the member to present a speech on any topic, receive feedback, and apply the feedback to a second speech. Timer, please note that the time allotted for the speech is 5 to 7 minutes. I will note down my observations and will be presenting the report in the general evaluation segment and called upon by GE. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Digant. And friends, do you know that people who like purple and pink have which kind of personality? People who like purple and pink are very sensitive in nature. Whenever you go for any kind of help, they help you out. But when they need help, then situation may not be the same. And that time they feel bad, especially the purple color person. They feel bad. They are introvert. They do not express you, but they feel bad when we do not help them. Similarly with pink color person like to receive nurturing in return. And so friends, be careful whenever any person is helping you out, just help them out in return, especially in this pandemic time. So friends, Toastmaster Akriti is already, and it's time to welcome Toastmaster Akriti Jain. Do you know you, Toastmaster Akriti Jain? Toastmaster Akriti, screen is all yours. You can start. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. I just want to do a quick check. Am I audible? A quick thumbs up by anybody will do. Okay, great. Thank you. So, good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Today, I want you to think of me not as Akriti, a girl you know, born and brought up in Delhi, a partner, a member of CDTM. No. Think of me as a man named Aaron. So, this man named Aaron is a Jew by religion and a psychiatrist by profession. All right. So now, it is a well-known fact that in Germany, under the reign of Hitler, Jews were treated brutally. And I am being very kind when I say brutal. So me and my family were all sent to gas ovens under the Nazi Germany. There we experienced things that were so repugnant to our sense of decency that I shudder to even repeat them in books. My whole family was sent to gas ovens. Every day, we were being herded like cattle. not knowing that the path that we are leading to is going to lead us to a gas oven, or it is going to lead us to the ones who are supposedly safe and shoveling the ashes of those who hated us. But then one day, my life changed for good. That one day, I was sitting in a small dark room, naked, both physically and mentally. And I pondered, what is that one freedom that these Nazi captivators cannot take away from? Sure, they can control my entire environment. They can choose what they wanted to do with my body, but they could never interfere with my identity as a person. So I get to decide how all of this is going to affect me. So in between what happens to me, which we call as the situation, and between my responses was the freedom that I was looking for, the freedom to choose how I respond towards the situation. And so in the middle of this ghastly situation of shoveling ashes, people around me being dying all the time, I would imagine myself under different circumstances. Like if I'm shoveling the ashes, I would project myself in my mind, lecturing students after my release from the death camps, giving them lectures about what I was learning during this torture. And through a series of such mental exercises, my freedom grew large and large until I had more freedom than my Nazi captivators. Sure, they had more options to choose from in their environment, but I had more internal power to exercise my option, my response. Aaron became an inspiration to those around him, even to some of the guards. He helped others find meaning in their suffering. But when you come to think of it, what was that one exercise that helped him fail this torture? Well, he used the power of self-awareness. But not all of us have been to concentration camps, so thankfully. So how do we relate to self-awareness? Well, let's put it to context right away. For the next few seconds, don't look at me. Don't look at me. Rather, try to project your own mirror image in any empty corner, if possible, of your room. Try to see, I'm assuming that all of you are sitting in front of your screens, mobile or laptop, listening to Akriti's speech. So try imagining or projecting your own mirror image, doing just what you are exactly doing right now. Can you see yourself as though you were somebody else, through the eyes of your mind, as a third person? Try doing that. Well, your ability to do what you have just done is uniquely human. Only Kashish, Kartik, Gosifar, Deepak sir, Digant, only and all the attendees in the group, and otherwise all the humans you know, only the human beings are capable of doing it. What I mean is animals do not possess this ability of being self-aware. So what actually is self-awareness? This self-awareness is thinking, being the ability of thinking about your own thought process, about your thoughts, feelings, having complete awareness about that. So this is the reason why human beings have dominion over all the things in the world, and why we have been able to make advances from generation to generation. Self-awareness also helps us in evaluating and learning from our experiences and the experiences of others, just like we do at Toastmasters. So if at all self-awareness is so important, how do we enhance and improve this ability of being more self-aware? Well, I have a few tips that I can share. First, practice guided meditation. Focus on that present moment for that little while and think about your thoughts and emotions, but without getting wrapped up in them. So if you want to practice this, you can practice it today, right now, a few minutes later. So in the next segment, table topic, When the table topic master asks you to volunteer, do not think of the future. Live in the present and raise your hand. Participate. Second, understand what impact you have on others and others' perspectives of you. Why? Why do I say that? Because oftentimes our image of oneself is so delusional that it hampers our group. So seek feedback from the people you love or those who you trust. Just like I will be seeking feedback from my evaluator and the team of evaluators in the evaluation segment. And lastly, learn a new skill. You know how we say for traveling, it puts us into new situations and enhances our perspective. In the same way, when you learn a new skill, your mind works like that of a baby. And how do you describe the mind of a baby? Freshness and flexibility. So go out of your way to be a beginner. For me, that skill was public speaking. And my coach is my amazing and wonderful team here at Toastmasters. And I am committed to achieve new heights of public speaking through my journey here. Thank you, and back to the Toastmaster of the day.
Friends, I request everyone, please unmute yourself because you have given appreciation to the latest speaker. Why not Toastmaster Akriti? And she is putting hard effort for leadership role and as well as for the communication. Great job, well done. And friends, what I liked is that she has included the table topic segment and her evaluator name also. So I'm sure she's going to get good marks from him, certainly. So friends, who is excited for the next segment? Please raise your hand. Who is excited? Toastmaster is excited. Anyone? So two members are excited. Only two. We need at least 5-6 persons for this segment. Our counter is also excited. Evaluator is also excited. So friends, since 5-6 persons are excited, I believe remaining 20 are also excited. They are just thinking I should raise. If I raise, then TTTA master will call me. So friends, with this, I hand over stage our table topic master. Toastmaster Darshan is all ready for performing his role. And I am not going to take much time so that he can invite more persons. Stage is all yours, Toastmaster Darshan.
I'm audible. Hello. I'm audible and visible.
Yes, yes, you are.
Toastmaster of the day.
Yes, you are.
Okay. So yeah, hi. Good evening, everyone. I am Darshan and the today's table topic master. So my fellow Toastmasters and guests, how a full rainbow with red emotions, orange energy, yellow joy, green hope, blue vision, indigo depth, and violet soul can be felt. Yes, it's all impromptu. How we change our feelings in accordance with the life. That is impromptu, right? Without being prepared and organized. Impromptu helps in learning the art of improvisation whenever we are in interview. It helps in developing the vital communication skills. Well, the topic that I have prepared for you today will hopefully help us all in the future and better at the improvisation. This session is not for just the members. The guests can also participate, and that brings excitement. The segment is open to everyone, so I request everyone to volunteer. I will randomly call anyone of the participants, or you can volunteer yourself by raising your hand in the chat box. The guidelines for the table topic session is 1 to 2 minutes you have to speak. 1 minute is a minimum, and 1:30 and 1 minute 30 seconds is a target time. 2 minutes is a maximum time. Speakers are allowed to speak for maximum time of 2 minutes and 30 seconds. That will be disqualified. That will lead you to disqualification. Okay. So I think let us begin this round. So who is going to volunteer first? I want members to come up first. Anyone from members would like to volunteer first? Anyone? Okay, so guest Arpit is raising his hand. First, I want any member to
Toastmaster Darshan, Toastmaster Digant, and Toastmaster Kashish are raising their hands.
Okay, so Toastmaster Kashish. I want Toastmaster Kashish. So, are you up for this? So, Toastmaster Kashish?
Yes, yes, I am up for this.
Okay, so your topic for today is online space only cause for fake news? I repeat, is online space only cause for fake news? Toastmaster Kashish.
Okay, thank you so much. If only online platform causes fake news, I think that is also fake, because at the time when there were no online platform, the people used to deliver the speeches, deliver the news via newspapers, or just by getting physical over there, watching them live the incidents. And at that time, how rumors were spread? I don't think that only online can cause fake news, because at that time it was more and more easier to spread fake news. Like, see, in a situation in 1920 when such a pandemic we faced, at that time there were many rumors, there are still many rumors, that more than 1 crore people died. Some people say that more than one, some people say that less than 1 lakh. And how will you believe? And that will are rumors. We don't know the exact situation at that time. And if we see in another platform, online platform can spread rumors, but no. In my point of view, if we are physical, if we are spreading it by day-to-day conversation, it can also spread more frequently. Because if you see any online information that is not correct, we can report it, that it is not correct. Even though one person can report it and the entire people will get to know it. But in offline, we can't do it. We just can be limited on ourselves. So that's why I think it is wrong. It is also fake. So I will hand over to it. Thank you so much, Darshan.
Thanks a lot, Kashish. It was a wonderful talk about the rumors you talked about. We should not believe in all the rumors. Let the correct information reach us. So the next volunteer, anyone is up? Toastmaster Digant, are you up for it? Okay, so Toastmaster.
Yes, I am in the field.
Okay, so I should go first with that with the TM Digant. Okay, so Toastmaster Digant, your topic is, if you are made the Chief Minister of Delhi for a day, how would you react to COVID situation currently? I repeat, if you are made the Chief Minister of Delhi for a day, how would you react to the COVID situation currently?
Okay. As I have become the Chief Minister for Delhi for one day, my first task will be, I will tell my last death wish to my lawyer, that okay, now managing Delhi is not an easy job in the pandemic time especially. So just I'm telling you, in case if I pass out in the office, you will have to honor that wish. And after that, what I will do is I will give the ray of hope to every Delhiite. I remember an incident, and same thing I will do as per the situation. Once Ratan Tata was going along with, Ratan Tata or JRD Tata was going with his friends on a road trip to some business meeting. And there the car broke down. As people were busy in repairing the tires, they saw that Ratan Tata, the business tycoon and the head of the Tatas, one of the flag bearers of Indian economy, just rolled up his sleeves, and he went on and got busy in changing the tire. And I will also do the same, although I will not change the tire in Delhi, but I will do the same thing. I will, even if it takes me to go on the streets of Delhi to help out people, I have seen even Gurudwara organizing oxygen langar, that is really a commendable job. I will help out people by going to those langars. I will help out each and every person, whoever I can. Because this also implements in Toastmasters when leaders actually roll up their sleeve and get onto the ground to work. It gives hope to not just leaders, but also to the members. Thank you.
Thanks a lot to Toastmasters again. Thanks a lot. So, anyone from the guests would like to volunteer? Okay, so guest, I can see guest Rupal Jain has raised his hand. So, guest Rupal Jain.
Yeah, am I audible and visible?
Yeah, you're absolutely audible and visible. So, your topic for today is, do you think reading fiction is a waste of time? I repeat, do you think reading fiction is a waste of time? Rupal Jain.
Thank you, Toastmaster Darshan, for giving me the topic. I believe that reading fiction or non-fiction, both is a productive in measure, as it, firstly, it inculcates a regular reading habit and also imparts a variety of knowledge and imagination to its readers. Like, just imagine a person, a kid growing up, who have seen just the world around him through the eyes of his parents and his school life. He doesn't know what the actual world entails, what different experiences and lifestyle he can pursue. But through the pages of a book, he can imagine much more. So where comes the difference of fiction or non-fiction? Fiction is just a kalpanik kahani. But for non-fiction, it comes through a real-life experience that is more productive, that it tells the real-life experiences in a much more focused manner. And it is more philosophical in generally. So what I recommend is you should always go for non-fiction. If you have a little bit experience afterwards in life. So that's it from me. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir. Rupal Jain, it was encouraging words. Okay, so now I would like Toastmaster Khare sir to come up. Khare sir?
Yeah.
Hello, sir. Your topic is...
Yeah. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely, sir. So your topic
is... Yeah, okay,
is,
what is that?
Your topic is, my biggest concern for the future is... My biggest concern for the future is.
Okay. So, if it is personal future or it is a country future, that is a question arises. So here I would like to throw some light on our country's future, because the kind of situation is going around, it is reflecting the personal lives. And if that all set, then maybe we will have an amicable situation throughout. I would like to throw light on some basic things which any country must have for their citizen. And it is imperative for all the country to must have these kind of things necessarily. I would like to point out the number one thing is the health of its citizen. If you go around the world, each country you will find then they have the basic free facilities for the people, those who can't afford, or even if can afford, the basic health care facilities are provided everywhere, and that is not provided in our country. Number two, the basic education. Basic education also is a free. In like countries in USA, it is free. But in our country, the basic education is very high. Or if it is in government schools, then it is the quality of education is poorer. And these are the two backbone of any country, which can be a game changer in any country's perspective or in any future of the country. So if we will not work on that, or rather we might be bringing the bullet trains, or we might be bringing a lot of technology, but we would not be considering these fundamental things, then we could not expect a good future. And then I think anybody, any government should think and take it on a priority basis to just do some transformation in that particular area. And that I raised this concern from this platform, then okay. That is my concern, and I have shared my point. Over to you, Table Topic Master.
Thank you, sir, for the great words. Thanks a lot. Now, I would like to call up Arpit. Are you up, Arpit? Arpit, are you there? You raised your hand. Arpit Kapoor.
Yes, Arpit, your audio is not, you're not audible. Could you please check your audio?
We cannot hear you, Arpit. Tarshan, you can pick someone else then.
Anyone up for the volunteer from the guests?
Guests or any Toastmasters as well? Arpit, you're not audible. I mean, there is an issue. You're just not audible. Someone's please volunteer. Pooja?
Anyone wants to volunteer?
Yeah, Pooja, you should volunteer now, I think.
So Faiz Kamil is raising his
hand. I think Pooja is ready. You can give her the topic.
Okay, so Pooja. Okay. So Pooja, Toastmaster Pooja, are you up? Toastmaster Pooja?
Yes.
Okay, so yeah. So your topic is, it is better to be influential than a rich person. I repeat,
hello.
It is better to be
influential
than a rich person. Arpit, we'll take you after this, if you don't mind.
All right, thank you so much, Toastmaster Darshan, for the topic. Yes, absolutely. It's I'll just repeat the topic. It's better to be influential than rich, right? Am I audible?
Yes, absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah, so the topic is it's better to be influential than rich, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay.
Definitely it's we will be in a more better position if we are more influential rather than rich. It is easy to earn money in today's generation with so much of access to qualification and knowledge. We can definitely have good salary, afford a good lifestyle, but being influential comes with a lot of attitude, lot of capability. One needs to have a lot of willpower and knowledge to be influential, to be able to lead people. That's all. Thank you.
All right. It's okay. You spoke really well. So, Arpit, are you up? Have you done with your mic?
Am I audible now?
Yeah, absolutely. You are absolutely audible. So your topic is Virat Kohli is the most successful captain of India, but he still doesn't have any ICC trophies. Why? I repeat, Virat Kohli is the most successful captain of India, but he doesn't have any ICC trophies yet. Why?
Arpit. Virat Kohli is the most successful captain of India, but still he hasn't received any trophies. But I suppose there were earlier also captains who were much better than him. It's a chance that we are judging the captainship right now. And we haven't had any recent testing being done by the world. Like ICC hasn't tested right now that who is the number one in India. And earlier also we had when we won the World Cup with Kapil Dev and all those individuals, they were much more experienced. And before Virat Kohli, I would say this helicopter captain, I'm not able to get his name. He was also not that bad. He was also much better, much more experienced than him. And simply claiming that Virat Kohli is the most successful captain is not the right thing. Let him play 2-3 games. Let him face the World Cup. Let him face the 2020s also. So in all those cases, when he will face 3-4 innings, then only we can claim him as the best captain. He will have to surpass the other previous individuals who were ruling that team. So, and he should also achieve some earnings also. Like he should achieve some game points also. So just simply he is the current captain. We cannot claim that he's the best captain. So current captain doesn't claim him to be the best. He's a good individual. He's a good player. He's a good batsman. I agree with that. But he has to prove his capability as a captain also. He has to go through that struggle, that hardship also, where he has to give. Mahendra Dhoni, as I am able to recall him now, Mahendra Dhoni was known as a captain cool also. He was better in managing the team. So if you compare, my personal view would be Virat Kohli is not as capable. Okay, I would like to stop here. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, Arpit. It was really kind words for Virat Kohli and Mahendra Singh Dhoni. So I would like to conclude the table topic sessions with the, we have time constraints. So you all have to wait for the evaluation round. So it was really encouraging and wonderful to have you all. Thank you all. And now I would like to give it back to TMOD.
Thank you so much, table topic master, Toastmaster Darshan. Friends, anyone who like color brown? No one likes color brown. Anyway, I will share, because I have prepared, so I will share. So people who like brown color are salt of the earth kind of people. They're both feet planted on the ground. They are committed to their job and responsibilities. Family is very important for them. And they take criticism very constructively. So friends, it's time to welcome our next role player, our general evaluator, who is going to start general evaluation segment. And her favorite color is color number green. Already explained, so no need to talk about it further. So please welcome our general evaluator, Toastmaster Shivali. Toastmaster Shivali, stage is all yours. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Now, good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. Being a general evaluator, I'll be doing three things. First, I will evaluate the speech evaluator. Second, I will be evaluating the reports given by our auxiliary role players. And
sorry to interrupt. Actually, I forgot to take the ballots. So let's take a ballot for the best speaker and also for the best table topic speaker so that then afterwards you can proceed with. I request that Tech Master to release the ballot.
Guys, vote very quickly, please. Just 5 more seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we are closing the polls. Now we are going to release the polls for the best table topic speaker. All right, we had quite a lot of table topic speakers today. just 10 seconds to vote. Vote very quickly, please. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Please vote very quickly. It's a very close contest. 8, 5 people are yet to vote. 9, one more second to decide the winner. All right, 10 and we are closing the polls.
Thank you so much. Toastmaster Shivari, you can proceed with. And sorry for the interruption.
It's okay, sir. Now you have made my work easy. Like I have to, you know, cut this recommendation. Thank you. Okay, guys, as I was telling that I have 3 things to do. 2 I've already explained. Third one is that I'll be sharing my observations regarding meeting Indians. So without wasting the time, let me start the speech evaluation segment. For that, I would like to invite our first evaluator, Toastmaster Simran, to evaluate Toastmaster Ruhi's speech. Over to you, Toastmaster Simran.
Below is my report. The speech was well structured with a proper introduction, body, and a perfect conclusion. The speaker started the speech with a quote, which gave an impressive touch to the speech. Hearing the speech, I can write a complete essay on her life. Thus, she explained her role so well. So thus, the objectives of the speech were fulfilled. She talked about various phases of her life, like that of innocence, independence, enlightenment, and many more. She also talked about her future ambitions, her school life, and her college life. And thus, everything was covered of her life in the speech. So also, she gave a morale at the end of every phase. And this, I like this very much because it helped to make the speech more clear. She was crystal clear in her speech and every aspect was very clear. She maintained a proper eye contact throughout the speech. She was standing throughout the speech and it gave a very impressive touch. So coming to the recommendations, I think that she could, she was using some hand gestures during her speech, but they were not so visible. So the position of the camera or the device can be adjusted so that the hand gestures can be seen. And she can also practice them in front of a mirror. And she could also talk about the family background in her speech. So these are the recommendations. Overall, it was a great speech. And I would like to wish best of luck to the speaker for further speeches. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Simran, for your wonderful report. Now I would like to invite our second evaluator, Toastmaster Karan V, to evaluate Toastmaster Shivangi's speech. Over to you, Karan V.
A very good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests once again. I'm sure we all heard Toastmaster Shivangi's speech with full interest. It is always said that never settle for mediocrity. I'm sure we all have heard such a quote earlier. But Toastmaster Shivangi, the speaker today, showed us how to do that. From a module we had last week about how to write a perfect speech, she learned all of it and applied all of it in today's speech of hers. When she came up on the stage, right in the first second when I saw her inside the frame, I knew something special was coming up. Why? She had a customized Zoom space set up for her. She was standing, she was conversational, her hand gestures were talking to me. And that's the quality of a great speaker. Her camera setup, which she had, allowed her to be very conversational. And of course, since you're conversational, the voice modulation becomes very natural. So this is a very key takeaway from her speech. The speaker, as she came up on the stage, gave us a quick introduction about herself. And then she told about different experiences in her life, starting from her college and then to be the youngest Toastmaster in the club. All the time, her hand gestures, conversation styles, everything was perfectly in sync with the way she was talking, the content she was delivering. So 10 on 10 on the delivery part. And throughout your speech, I think the thing which impressed me the most was the delivery part. At the same time, I would like to suggest you to work on your content a little. Why I am saying so? At some points in your speech, I felt you were talking about multiple things. There were various topics you were trying to talk about, one of them being when you started choosing the content on your Instagram so that you can improve yourself. The other one was the coronavirus. Third one being the Toastmaster, youngest Toastmaster in the club. So since you had multiple topics, it made me wonder, where are you going with this? And given your topic never settled, and I was completely lost, where is she going with this about this content, and how is it related to her topic? So I would suggest the speaker to work on this part so that the audience can know where are you going with the topic. Also, I would love to know what kind of person you are. You, of course, about your experiences, about different college first, having gone to college online in the first year. I'm sure that's a nightmare. But I would also love to know how are you as a person. So overall, you were totally amazing on the delivery part. It is not something that most icebreaker teachers have done on the stage. But kudos to you for having done that. You had the courage to come up on the stage and set it on fire. This icebreaker speech is a chance for us to discover our strengths and weaknesses. I'm sure you have discovered those, and this will help you improve in the next speech. My key take from your speech is to be conversational with the audience, and everything will be taken care of. All the best, Toastmaster Shivangi, for your speeches. Thank you. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Karanvi, for your encouraging evaluation. Now, I would like to invite our third evaluator, Toastmaster Digan, to evaluate Toastmaster Akriti's speech. Over to you, Toastmaster Digan.
Thanks, Madam General Evaluator. I have a query. Is my speaker Akriti Jain or someone else? Actually, I noticed that she started with such an interesting start. Do not consider me as Akriti. I got curious, okay. What I need to consider you as? So this was really an interesting start that I saw that completely grabbed my attention. Also, I noticed that the speaker had really good hand gestures, which were in complete synchronization with all the things that she was narrating throughout this. And not just that, whenever she was not having any use of using hand gestures, she didn't use hand gesture at that moment. She just kept her hands low. So that didn't distract me also. So this was really a commendable thing on the part of our learned speaker. However, I have two recommendations regarding the speech. First, I noticed that the speaker was facing some glitch in the speech. So she was referring to the whole script. In this case, I would suggest to her that she can actually make some pointers cards, writing the points of the speech, and just keep it in front of her for the time being, that the smoothness is not there as per the practice. She can keep in front of her just those cards, and whenever, in case if she forgets, although I wish she doesn't forget, but in case if she forgets any point, then she can actually refer to those cards and explain the point as a table topic matter also. As a table topic point also, she can explain it over there and successfully complete her speech. My second recommendation is, I noticed that the pace of speaking was fast. I suggest in this case two things that our speaker can do. First, before beginning the speech, she can take few deep breaths, which can actually prepare her for the speech. Secondly, what she can do is, while preparing for the speech, she can take the matter that she have to give in the has to give in the speech and practice it as per different speed of the speeches. However, I would like to commend our speaker again for making it a very interactive speech, giving it a much more persuasive element, like "don't look at me," etc., which were in direct conversation with the audience, as well as she connected to audience also by taking names of people from the audience. Apart from this, there was a clarity of thoughts by the speaker also, as she was showing the points by mentioning, emphasizing the points by showing it as 1, 2, first point, second point, third point. So all in all, speaker did a fantastic job with a good, interesting start, a very interactive and persuasive speech, connecting to the audience. Just by working upon her pace of speaking, she can actually take her public speaking to another. Thank you. Over to general evaluator.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster.
Audible, guys?
Shivali, you are audible.
Okay, thank you so much, Toastmaster Digant, for your detailed evaluation. Now, I would like to invite our table topic evaluator, Toastmaster Gajendra, sir. Over to you.
I am not a table topic evaluator because you can ask. Kasis has given this role to someone else.
Okay, sir. Toastmaster Karthik, may I know who is TT evaluator?
Let me check with Kasis himself. Kasis, who has got the table topics evaluation?
DTM Sriram was said to me that DTM Sriram will come and he will be the table topic evaluator by as per the agenda that Simran was saying.
All right. General evaluator, your call. If you want to give some feedback to the table topics evaluator, you can give it by yourself.
That's an impromptu because I wasn't aware. But thank you so much, Toastmaster Karthik, for this wonderful opportunity. As I observed all the table topic speakers, so I must say that every Toast table topic speaker showed the courage and came on the stage by learning and showing the capacity that, yes, we have this courage to speak on impromptu topics. I love the way every speaker understood the topic and tried to give their level best. So the only recommendation I have for such speakers who felt that they could speak more but they couldn't, so guys, keep coming on the table, keep coming in the table topic segment and try to speak more, and one day you will see that you are able to speak like you'll be able to speak on the spot like that you have already prepared. That is what I've observed. That's all from my side. Thank you so much. And now I would ask the Toastmaster Karthik to please release the ballot for the best evaluator, Toastmaster Simran, Toastmaster Karandeer, and Toastmaster Digant Mittal. Is the voting done?
Yes. Let's just end the polls now.
Fine. So now, guys, this is the time to invite our auxiliary role players to know their reports. So first, I would like to invite our timer Toastmaster Mehir. Over to you, Toastmaster Mehir.
Good evening once again, everyone. So here is my report. For the prepared speeches, TM Ruhi took 5 minutes 49 seconds. TM Shivangi Mittal took 4 minutes 51 seconds. And TM Akriti Jain took 7 minutes 18 seconds. For the table topics, TM Kashish took 2 minutes 20 seconds. TM Digant Mittal took 2 minutes 23 seconds. Guest Rupal Jain took 1 minute 45 seconds. TM Gajendra Khare took 2 minutes 3 seconds. TM Pooja took 58 seconds. And guest Arpit took 2 minutes and 6 seconds. For the speech evaluators, TM Simran Dua took 1 minute 44 seconds. TM Karanveer took 3 minutes 23 seconds. And TM Digant Mittal took 4 minutes and 7 seconds. That's all from my side. Back to you, journal evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Mehir. Now, I would like to invite our language evaluator, Toastmaster Vinny. Over to you.
Thank you, General Evaluator Shivani. So the first thing I would like to point out is that the word of the day was not used at all throughout the meeting. So I would like to reiterate the importance of learning new vocabulary words throughout these meetings so that we have a better way of communicating. So there were good usages of words which were used, such as sacrosanct, repugnant, and ghastly. And the translations were also done properly during one of the speeches by Speaker Shivangi. There were few instances where the usages were not so good. Like, for example, one of the speakers said didn't knew. In fact, it should have been didn't know. And the second example was kid grown up who have. Instead, it should have been kid growing up who has. That's all from my end. Back to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Shubhini. Now, I would like to invite our counter, Toastmaster Faiz. Over to you.
Thank you. Thank you, General Evaluator. I have my reports ready. Toastmaster Tarun said 11 fillers words, and guest Rupal Jain 11, TM Kashish 3, and TM Akriti had one long pauses, TM Gajinder 4, TM Pooja 5, TM Arpit 6. That's all. Over to you.
Thank you, our counter. Next, our parliamentarian, Toastmaster Tarun. Over to you.
Yeah, very good evening to the ladies and gentlemen once again. I appreciate you all that the whole rules have been followed up by the members, except the one thing I observed that few members doesn't turn on the videos. So I request you to them to understand the essence of switch on the video and could not do the same from the next meet. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Now, last but not least, I would like to invite our listener of the day, Toastmaster Kashish. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Shivangi. It was a wonderful meeting which I felt. And as per I said, I will be back with my questions. So are you guys ready to answer my questions? I hope you are. So my first question for the day is, mention in two phases in the life of Ruhi, as per our first speaker, Ruhi told us. Any two phases? Please raise your hands. If anyone knows, there were four. No one? Anyone with one?
I see guest Rupal Jain raising his hand.
Yeah. Go for it, Rupal Jain.
I remember her last phase that there is a pursuing MBA.
PGDM. Okay. Yeah, you are somewhere right, but it's not the perfect one. There were four phases, so I should tell it myself. There were four phases. The first one was innocence. The second one was independence. The third one was enlightenment. And the fourth one was never to settle. Okay, it seems to be a little hard question, but coming to my second question, what is Shivangi expecting at the last of her speech currently, as per her speech? Second speaker, Shivangi.
Pandemic to end. Yes, so that she can go to her college.
Yes, you are right. She is expecting to finish the pandemic. I would request to please raise up your hand so that I can see how many people know the right answer. Okay, coming to my third question. What was the title of Toastmaster Akriti, who was our third speaker? Please raise your hand. Anyone?
Should I?
Yeah, you should. If no one's there.
Her topic was, do you know you?
Oh, great. Great listening abilities, my bro. Well done. Keep it up. Okay, my fourth question for the day is, what are the two things that Toastmaster Gajendra Khare mentioned that should be done for our country's future? Two backbone things which he recommended. Please raise your hand. Okay, I am seeing Toastmaster Shivali, Toastmaster Arpit. Okay, I will give it to our guest, Arpit Kapoor. Please go forward. You are on mute. Please unmute yourself.
Health and education as the priority of the state should be there. Health and education.
Yeah, free health and free education. That's very nice of you. Thank you so much, guest Arpit. Okay, my fifth question for the day is the last question. Toastmaster Akriti, our third speaker, mentioned three points which should be kept in mind to improve self-awareness. Anyone who knows all the three or two? I'll ask for two, if anyone knows. Please give it a try. Anyone? No one? One? Okay, and last, I have to answer it. So there were three. First was guided meditation. Tarun, you want to answer?
Yeah, the one was guided meditation. Yes.
Yeah, great. Thank you so much. Okay, the second, the left two are, understand what other people's illusion is for yourself, and you also understand how you have for other people. And the third was be a beginner so that you can learn. Okay, thank you so much. I hope it was an engaging session. And be an attentive listener for the rest of the meeting. It will help you a lot. Thank you so much. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Akshish, to make us realize how it is important to be attentive to the meeting. Now, let's vote for the best auxiliary role player. And the polls are there on our screen. In few seconds.
Vote very quickly, guys, please. 10 seconds. 1, 2. Okay, listener was Kashish. The name had been pre-fed. Kashish took the role right before the meeting. So Tanvi, you can consider as Kashish. 5, 6, 7. Guys, there are still 8 to 9 people who haven't voted. Please vote very quickly. And those who've turned off the video, you can have your Maggies and tea later. Please vote. All right, someone mute themselves also. All right, just 2 more seconds. 9, 10 and we have a winner. All right, guys. Yes, please carry on the general evaluator. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Karthik. So now the time has come to give my report. So guys, I would start from the beginning that our meeting started sharply at 7:15. Kudos to EC members to start all the time on time. And this is something which makes me curious to attend our club's meeting. Great job. Coming to the sergeant at arms, as we always see, Toastmaster Kashyap starts the meeting passionately by clearly reading out the mission of the club, which inspires us all the time. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Kashyap, for the wonderful start. Second, our presidential address. So today also, our president came up with a great story to give a wonderful message, which is again a takeaway for me, and I think for most of us. And he introduced the guest very warmly, which is one of the best part of Toastmaster Club. Keep doing good work, Toastmaster Karthik. Coming to our Toastmaster of the day. We have a lot of commendation, guys. I love the way Toastmaster Ankit sir brought up that amazing theme, which is related to color. So, sir, I would say whatever I have made a note in my notebook. So first thing, you brought up a very interesting theme, which I loved throughout the meeting. And I saw one uniqueness that today all the auxiliary role players try to connect with the theme. And that is something make us curious and interesting. So great job to decide the theme for today's meeting. Next, I would say in one line that our Toastmaster of the day met all the criteria being a great host today. Let me just tell you what comes in that criteria. First, our Toastmaster of the day engaged the audience by applying, I would say, a wonderful approach that is called a conversational approach, where throughout, sir was asking questions to engage the audience, and that made me engaged throughout the meeting. Great job, sir. Next, I love the idea to describe different personalities with the help of colors, and I got to know about my personality as well, and honestly, somewhere I agree with you that I feel like, yeah, I have such kind of personality. So thank you so much for that. Next, our Toastmaster of the day clearly told us what is the structure of the meeting for the benefit of the guest. So I'm sure guests got the clear idea what is going to happen next 1 to 2 hours. Last but not least, our Toastmaster of the day introduced each and every role player, but in a different way. So generally what we do that before calling our role players, we introduce themselves. But sir did something different. Like what he did, first he invited the auxiliary, like all the role players. And after that, he introduced themselves by telling their favorite colors and the personality. I totally love that idea. Only one recommendation I have for sir, as we all know that for icebreaker speech, in our Toastmaster community, this is the culture to tell for the benefits of the guests that for delivering icebreaker speech, we need to give them standing ovation. Though, sir handled it very nicely to ask everybody to unmute themselves and give a big round of applause for our all the speakers. So I love that way, sir. Other than that, I love your hosting. Keep doing good work. Coming to the, our speech evaluator. So all the speech evaluators were experienced except Toastmaster Simran. She did a dividend role, which I really like because all the roles use CRC approach. As you know that, C is commendation, R is recommendation, and C is again commendation. I love the way our evaluators encouraged our speakers, and whatever commendation and recommendation they gave, I totally agreed with them. So I don't have any recommendation except one that... I believe that one of our evaluators used he or she. I believe that we are told to avoid using he, she. Why? Because this evaluation is for everybody so that everyone can learn that how can we deliver a perfect speech. So we can use those speaker term, which is always good to give your evaluation. Other than that, fabulous evaluation, guys. Now moving towards our auxiliary role players. So I would say today I saw some dividend role players. So guys, kudos to you. You did a wonderful job. by introducing your roles very well and by giving a thorough report. The only recommendation I have for the timer, what I believe that timer did not, I think timer missed out that part where timer should have told that what is the allotted time for every speech and the evaluation segment. So we could work on it. Other than that, every report was crisp and nice. I have forgotten to mention Table Topic Master. So guys, Table Topic Master was also debuted today and he gave his level best. Why I'm saying this? Because I remember when I did TTM first time, I forgot something, which I did not. But today at TTM, Table Topic Master did not forget anything. He came up with a wonderful topic and he explained the role very well. The only recommendation for Table Topic Master is that this segment is conducted for all the members who haven't taken part. So I would suggest to first call up the experienced one so that guests can have the idea what is going to happen in this segment, but later on try to give chances to those people who haven't taken any role in the meeting. Otherwise, you did a wonderful job. I'm sure I have, I've mentioned everybody. And the last suggestion I would like to give to EC to, manage all the roles prior to the meeting and be updated it so that during the meeting, we don't need to search for the role players. Otherwise, guys, wonderful job. Keep doing it. Thank you so much. Over to Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Madam General Evaluator, for such a detailed report covering everything in such a short span of time. And friends, anyone who like gray color? Rather, gray is one of my favorite color. People who like gray color are quite neutral for the life. They're quite indifferent. They just need safe, secure, and balanced environment. And they do not seek much attention from the others. They just need peace and harmony in their life as we are seeking in current days. Because we have realized in this pandemic time that peace and harmony and right of living is the most important right in current time. And with this hope that I hope that this time to end very soon and we have a normal life. And with this normal life, let's go back to our president. The state president, sir president, stage is all yours.
Thank you Toastmaster Ankit. Yes, we had a great meeting, a very interactive session today with our very experienced Toastmaster. And yes, I take it that all of you enjoyed it. It was pretty interactive and we had a good bunch of speakers as well. And I can now at least start to see some improvement in quality, except for that small thing that happened. I humbly apologize for that confusion that happened. But a great meeting today. And yes, well conducted. And we are on track, in fact, to finish it ahead of time. So at this point, let's have ballots for the best role player today. The grand prize, which is the Toastmaster of the Day, Toastmaster Ankit Sinha, Table Topics Master, Toastmaster Darshan Singh, and the General Evaluator, Toastmaster Shivali Chauhan. Guys, vote very quickly, please. We are in a tie. I'll give you 5 more seconds to break that tie. 1, 2, 3 more people are yet to vote. 3, 4 people. 3, 4. The more time I'm giving, the more closer you are bringing. Okay. 4, 5. All right, I'm closing the polls now. Thank you so much. All right, so before I announce the result, I would request all the guests to stay just for a few more minutes. I'll be announcing the winners and then we'll talk to all of you. And to all the new members that have just joined in, I thank you for really showing up and delivering speeches and taking auxiliary roles on consistent basis. Yes, our focus now is on quality. Until now, it was on getting members and keeping the club alive. And I apologize that the quality had slipped a little, but now we are back. We are also going to ensure that you have mentors allocated to you and you can reach out to them and discuss everything. But until we are there, because the situation is not so conducive, some people are unwell and hence there's a little shortage of mentors. Until we are there, the EC members will keep reaching out to you to answer all your doubts and to also give you feedback after every single meeting. All right, so it's time to announce the winners now. First up, the best auxiliary role player. We had timer Toastmaster Meher Kaur, language evaluator Toastmaster Vineet Nair, our counter Toastmaster Faiz, parliamentarian Toastmaster Tarun Nanda, and listener Toastmaster Kashish Jain, and joke master Toastmaster Pooja Kotecha. Any guesses, guys? Who won it? Take some guesses, guys. Where has all the energy gone?
Toastmaster Tanvi.
Kashish.
Toastmaster Tanvi. Yes, so it goes to Toastmaster Tanvi. Okay, Kashish Jain is the winner. Congratulations, Kashish. Okay, now let's have the results for the best evaluator. We have Toastmaster Simran Dua, Toastmaster Karanveer Singh, and Toastmaster Digant Mittal. Any guesses?
Our tech master.
Yes. He seems to be on a winning streak today. He's getting applause from every single corner. Congratulations, Toastmaster Karanveer Singh. All right. Let's have the best table topic speaker. We had, I think, 7 table topics speaker today. A great, great sign that people are volunteering to speak. So who won? Who was the best table topic speaker today?
Gajendra, sir.
Yes, it was a close contest, but Toastmaster Gajendra Khare edges past with the vote of the people who are organizing. Congratulations, Toastmaster Gajendra Khare. All right. I think the best speaker is still left. Yep. Toastmaster Ruhi, Toastmaster Shivangi Mittal, and Toastmaster Akriti Jain. Who was the best speaker today? We had two icebreakers today.
Toastmaster Shivangi. Toastmaster Shivangi.
Yes. Toastmaster Shivangi, you won by a very huge margin. Congratulations on being the best speaker on an icebreaker. All right, the grand prize now, the best role player. We had Toastmaster today, Toastmaster Ankit Sinha, Table Topics Master, Toastmaster Darshan Singh, and General Evaluator, Toastmaster Shivali Chauhan. Who was the best role player today?
Toastmaster Shivali.
Ankit, sir.
Any more Ankit, guesses? Sir. This is the last award.
Toastmaster Ankit, sir.
Yes, it was our very own Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Ankit Sinha, who won. Congratulations, sir. All right. Thank you, guys. I mean, it was a great, great meeting. Before I let you go, I request everyone to turn on your videos so we can have a picture. Shivali, Mehak, Khare sir, Digant, Kapil, if possible, if you can turn it on. If not, no worries. And Kashish, what pranks are you trying to play at the end? Now it's fine. Just 1 minute, guys. All right. Okay. Thank you, guys. Thank you for tuning in and supporting the club in these times. I am very confident that our club will again win so many awards. We've got so many members back, and it gives me more energy that we are going to achieve a lot of things. Deepak, sir, you wanted to say something.
Thank you, Mr. President. I just wanted to commend our Toastmaster of the day today because he demonstrated how the role of the Toastmaster needs to be served. And he did it in a commendable fashion. The fact is that when a Toastmaster of the day has a theme, usually they have a whole thesis to go along with the theme. But Ankit did a fine balance of providing us information about the theme, but yet kept it to the minimum so that we were able to complete this meeting on time. So a huge applause to our Toastmaster of the day, Ankit Sinha.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for providing that feedback. And this feedback was not just for Toastmaster Ankit Sinha. It is for all of you as well, who are members of our club. Please do note that we should keep a fine balance between the content. And yes, you heard this feedback from the best. And take it seriously, and we'll monitor as to how you take this.